Hi, this is Raj. I just would like to talk today about never give up attitude. This is very, very important. Especially during this pandemic time and those troubled times, you should have or maybe cultivate a built up an attitude called never give up. Let's get into today's small inspirational stories for you. I have a few thousands of rupees in my hand and I have some chillers in my hand. I put this, I don't think so there's any noise made by this notes, which is very valuable. And this chillers, definitely, of course, the chillers make sound. When your value goes up, you don't make noise at all. And you don't have value, you still make a lot of noise. It happens with you in the organization where you work in sometime, or maybe the industry you work in sometime. You can see that the lot of people who basically talk behind you, gossip about you, they will never get tired to talk bad about you. Many people. Just think that they are chillers and you have a higher value and hence you don't make sound. Always the people who make noises are chillers. Let's say that you have gone to watch a cricket match or a football match and you can see that the audience make a lot of noise there, and they just shout, they cheer up sometime, they argue sometime, they maybe criticize sometime. Have you ever seen a player making sound? No. So you are a player, the audience will definitely make a lot of noise, but not the player. So you have to cultivate an habit of never give up. Never accept failure at all. That should be your attitude. So let the chillers make noise and you have a value and you keep your value up and keep growing. I'm sure all of us have definitely our heroes for inspiration. I have two heroes which I'm going to talk about them is one is Abraham Lincoln, who was the president of the United States of America, and Sri Abdul Kalam. So you have two, great leaders whom I am very much inspired and I'm going to talk about them today. Abraham Lincoln was very poor, when the childhood was very poor, he was a lot of problems at home, he was in a very, very bad state. In his autobiography, he says that he used to get fear to go next to the scissors and the knives which has been kept there, or blades which been kept there, because he felt that he is getting an attitude to kill himself by seeing them, to suicide himself, to kill himself. So much of depression he had gone through. Very bad times he had gone through. He started his business. He was a failure. Again, he started another business. He was a failure. He came into the politics. He was a failure again and again. He was a failure. But then he had one great thing about him was he never ever given up. He never accepted the failure at all. Then rest is history. United States of America have never ever produced such a wonderful president, Abraham Lincoln, the most influential president of United States of America. So same way, Mr. Abdul Kalam, again, who is a great mentor for me, or very big inspiration for me, he actually wanted to become a pilot. So he had gone to write an exam. And there are 9 people where he went to write an exam. He found 8 people. When the result came in, 8 people got selected and one person was, rejected. And that one person was Sri Abdul Kalam. Just look at that. He was so upset. And he was outside the office. He was very upset and he was sitting almost with tears in his eyes. So the gentleman passed through and he found this boy is very upset and he asked this boy, "What happened to you? Why you're upset? What happened to you?" So Sri Abdul Kalamji said that, "What else, the worst thing happened in my life. What else you want me to, what bad thing can happen? This is something which is the worst thing happened. 9 people, 8 people got selected and I am the only person who got rejected." The gentleman said, "Don't, go with this result. There'll be something behind this. Maybe the God has thought something different for you. He wants something you to do different, you know, something totally different, or maybe something much, much bigger or better than what you are at the moment expecting. This guy, our Abdul Kalam, had felt that he's taken that word, something he felt, and he started working very hard. He worked very, very hard, and rest is history. You know that he became the president of India. One day, you know, the incident happened that he was flying by the supersonic plane. When he was landing, about to land, he could see that there are almost hundreds of pilots standing and saluting him. So that time he remembered that if I would have become a pilot, this day would have not come into me at all. This kind of respect I would have never got. The, you know, all these pilots were saluting the President of India because for his position and for this name and fame what he has got. So sometimes we all forget, or maybe all we feel that I have not got this today, and I'm supposed to get this today, and I did my best, but I lost this, and you just sit on it. Many people fail because they're afraid to start up because they feel that someone will comment bad on that. If I do it and it becomes wrong, there'll be a lot of people laughing at me. So many people stop or maybe don't even try to do it. You will only fail if you have done something. If you have not done something, you will never be a failure at all. So these are the two great leaders of our time where we can always take them as the biggest inspiration. I will definitely tell you to not to give up. Keep that attitude of not to give up and keep fighting, and I'm sure the success is in your hand one day. Thank you.